Hi, this is TapCat. Welcome back to part 4 of Let's Play XCOM 2 with the Alien Hunters and Shen's Last Gift DLCs. Well, this isn't just any old mission waiting for us. It's our first Retaliation. I'm a little nervous about it because at this level, it's just so hard bringing down Faceless along with whatever else they've thrown at us. But it's time. We got no choice but to take it on. I am going to gear up the squad a little bit. So let's start by coming here and grabbing a med kit. And you probably won't be shocked that I'm going to give it to our specialist. Now, while we're at it, I'm going to equip some other things. For example, the Hunter's Axe.
Maybe a little unwieldy, but in the right hands, this thing should cut down anything standing in your way.
And while I'm at it, let's grab the Shadow Keeper.
The way this one is sighted in, there's no excuse for missed shots.
Now, I thought about giving Lucas the Electrocaster. Alright, I will do it, but I'm sorry, I keep calling it the Electrocaster. The Bolt. Caster, forgive me.
It may only provide a single shot action, but this thing hits hard. Even an edge hit could potentially stun the target.
So I'm just gonna say this weapon is very much on probation with me. I didn't really like it in our last run, and if I find myself feeling the same way, we're gonna retire it really quickly. It hits hard, and I love the aim bonus, but I hate the constant need to reload. And I find it very limiting. Okay, now I am thinking we'll bring the frost bomb.
Charges in this grenade don't seem all that powerful, but according to Shen, the liquefied gases inside should lead to an instantaneous freeze effect.
All right, I think we've grabbed everything we can that'll help. Just got to go do it. Well, let's see. Obviously, we have somebody up here. Let's see if we can get to them safely. So, I can... If I want to dash, you know, I can do that. Problem is, like, just coming here, we could reveal somebody. I just don't dare do that.
Moving to designated position.
So, I'm going to group up as tightly as I can.
Rolling.
That way, if one of these guys is faceless too, we got it covered.
Overwatch.
Wow, they're close. Honestly, we might have triggered him if I'd have moved forward even those few tiles. Let's find out. Yes, no, yes. Yep, we would have. Now, I guess it's not 100% because it's possible they move forward, you know, after my turn. But it certainly feels as though we would have. So this is a little tricky. I'm not going to be able to flank for sure. And I have a very real possibility of taking return fire here, like fairly significant return fire. So I'm thinking... You know, I don't normally do this, but I think at least killing the trooper, because he's the one guy that we know for sure will take a shot. Granted, the other one could take a shot at the poor civilian. Okay, how can you... See... Alright, now I can shoot. So odd how it does that sometimes. But I can do that. Now, I mean, I feel like using her from here is something I can really only do if I know I can stay where she's at. This is a little risky, but I'm gonna do it. I want to get this guy out of here. Now, can I get the kill? I have a good chance. I'm gonna take this. Awesome. And now we're gonna see what kind of dent we can put in this other clown's hide. If he can hit, this'll go a long way. Okay, so leaving her here now, total non-starter. I'm not even considering it. So I'm just going to move behind full cover, which isn't that great. I mean, it helps her, but I got others behind half cover. One of them is flankable. But there's a good chance that he will simply turn the fallen trooper into a zombie. Man. Stop shooting them. No, he went for the flank, didn't he? Nope. So, he heads over. Oh, brother, he went for the mind spin and didn't get it. I mean, he had my ranger flanked. That's a pretty horrible decision-making process he just went through.
I'm ready.
So, I do have a pretty good shot there, but you know what's a much better shot? Yeah.
Heading there now.
Now, I could reveal another group. Okay, but I didn't. 100%. Good chance to crit. Yes. All right, they're done. No wounds taken. And no civilians lost, you know, in this area. Do we see any other civilians? It looks like there's one way over there, but wow. Really tough. Okay, so we've already used my ranger.
Let's
start moving forward. Okay.
Heading out.
Sure.
Orders confirmed. On the move.
Okay. So I'm just trying to move forward a little bit. We know there's a group over here killing civilians. I feel like probably the most efficient way to stop that is to just literally go get them. You know, as opposed to trying to, how can I say it? Trying to rescue this civilian or that civilian. I want them to see me, come to me, you know, and then, granted, they can still shoot guys during the fight, but bottom line is if they're dead, they stop killing dudes. I'm pretty sure there's this group, and then there's probably one more. And hopefully that's it. Okay, this is a pretty terrible place to stop. Man, I wish I could move and, okay, hold on. Love these defensive positions that we've got available. I feel very strongly that, I need to try and clear this herd a little bit. Oh, you guys, why did you have to split up so much? Okay, I tell you what. Let me do this. I'm just going to take the highest percentage throw I've got. Okay, good. That's pretty huge. Because now if I come over here, oh man, if this guy is a faceless, oh, that would be bad. What if I came here? I have to worry a little bit about that other group. Because this is not the only one, for sure. I'm going to do it. Okay. Now, I can use a grenade to break up cover. I'm just going to go ahead and take this shot. I don't think she's going to have a good shot no matter what I do. And well, I guess if I used a grenade, but I really don't want to do that.
Negative damage.
I think I'm just going to take a couple of crappy shots and see if I can make one pay. And the answer is no. No, in fact, I can't. So I could come here. He's very flankable. That's the problem. But he also is getting in a position to flank them, potentially. It's risky, but I'm going to try. If we can kill this trooper, that would go a long way. Awesome. Okay, so now I feel like the odds of one of us getting destroyed this turn just went way down. The odds of one of the civilians, that's a different story. So I gotta finish this officer and then go get that other group. Wow, that was a good shot. That was a good shot, but at least he's alive. Okay, let's do this. Let's get behind full cover. And then we'll see whether I can't shoot at him, so I guess I could heal him. That would definitely be a thing. Okay, I have a really, really crappy shot. His cover is destructible. I'm gonna say in this case, well, you know, I'm not gonna be able to get close enough to do anything with her. I was thinking maybe I could hold on. Wow. Okay, I tell you what I'm gonna do. This is so risky. So risky. Okay, we're going all in. I'm going to try and kill this guy this turn, but wow. Yeah, this is what I really want. Okay. We can do this. Yep. Now, not you. Although, that would be a really good shot if you had ammo. Oh, you can't see him now. She did before. That's so frustrating. Why does the game do that? You blow up cover in front of the guy, and now all of a sudden he's invisible. All right. Well, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to just come in as close as I can get. And I could use the sword, but this is 100%. Guaranteed. Money.
Kill confirmed.
Okay, let's put her on Overwatch.
Come get some.
And let's have him heal himself. Okay.
Give him a heal.
Okay. I consider that somewhat less than ideal.
We've heard rumors about some kind of shapeshifters. I'm guessing this is it.
It is a remarkable species. If only we had some means of containment.
Oh, he missed. Good, good, good. The question is, will you miss? I don't mean her. I mean it. I hope so. Because he's going to get a shot here. No whammies. Okay. That could have been a lot worse. Now, we have a couple ways to go here, and I need to see what else happens before I make up my mind. So, step one, we're going to make sure we can kill this guy. I need to know that someone besides Lucas can hit him. See? High percentage shot, but we missed. That's the problem. I can't. I'll reload and fire with him if somebody else hurts him. But I need that to happen. Otherwise, I gotta bail with him because he will die. All right, good job. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it now. And I still have my Ranger that I can use. Yeah, but he has 100%, and this weapon does a lot of damage. So, done deal. I just didn't feel like he was going to get 12 points of damage. That seemed, you know, super unlikely. So part of me wants to come over here and try to, you know, rescue one more guy. But do I want to reveal anybody right now? I don't think so. I need to reload. I will go on Overwatch from here, though. If they show their ugly faces... I actually think I may not have any choice but to start revealing these guys, though. Oh, look at this, though. We got to reload. This is so bad. Ready to go. But what am I up to? Yes, see, there's six guys left, and I need four of them. And one of the count might be a faceless. I don't even know. So for Lucas, my turn's pretty simple. I got to reload. And I'm actually thinking that what I may need to do, too, is use his second heal. Yeah, I think so. This is the last fight, and I don't want him to die. You know, three health. That's pretty much you're just guaranteed to get killed if anyone hits you. When do you ever get hit for two damage? So I need to reload. Oh, man, this is so tough. Yeah, I'm not going to come up here for the perch, but I'll bring her here. I feel like that's not only full cover, but a pretty good line of sight in that direction. Now, I normally do not do this, but I'm actually thinking I'm going to come up here. I'm going to intentionally trigger these guys in the... Well, or I'm not, actually. I thought I was going to trigger him. So I'll just put him on Overwatch. He's actually the only one I have left with actions. Oh, man. So if one more civilian dies, we lose this mission, I think. Oh, man. If we haven't already. Yep. That's not good. So what I have to do, if I don't want to fail, is move him forward. Even though all my other guys are a mile away. That's not good. Okay. See, she should be gone right now, but whatever. All right. Smart man moves him, you know, to cover. But I want the kill, so.
Taken care of.
Okay. Now. Can I get you close enough to help? Debatable. 29% is really crappy. You are not going to be able to see a damn thing from back here. So what we're going to do is move you here. This is not going to be a turn where we get a lot of kills. That's one reason. Oh, all right. Oh, well, whatever. It's one reason I took the one kill. You know, the chance at least of that kill was worth it to me. All right. I'm going to move him up here.
Moving out.
I mean, it should be pretty obvious. I'm trying to position myself to do real damage next turn. So the only thing I got to decide now is whether to take this shot. The penalty for Overwatch is bad enough. I'm just going to go ahead and do it. Yep, we got it. I felt like we basically had almost the same chance, and I'd rather know. So what are you going to do? Okay. Okay, that's not terrible. Okay. Okay, I feel pretty good about this, actually. So, here's the thing. I'm really grateful that she's not a faceless, by the way. So, I can come here, and I would say it's almost a guarantee I kill the sectoid. The problem, you know, how do I kill the trooper? Unless somebody else can kill the sectoid. And Christian can... Let me just make sure. Yes. Yes, he could come here or here, and pretty much guaranteed he can kill the trooper. So he can kill either one. I feel pretty comfortable. Oh, hold on. Just one second. I'm sorry. What's his weapon? Okay, it's 4-6. So it's not guaranteed that he would kill the sectoid. He would have a good chance to do that. All right, let's move Lucas up. Okay. That's risky. I mean, I'm kind of rolling all of the dice on that shot. Okay, look, she can only see the one guy. Let's see if I get this hit. No. Yeah, that makes it a lot harder, because if she did, I would have the flexibility of taking this shot, and then if he missed, she could finish him off, or it off. But see, now her shot alone won't kill it. All right, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to kill the zombie. And by try, I mean this should be pretty much a sure thing. Okay, done. And then I'm going to use my ranger to kill the trooper. And let's see. If I come here, I will have him flanked. That's what I'm seeing. Yeah. And the sectoid shouldn't even be able to see him. Okay, 100%. Done. Kill him. So now the only guy left on the board, there's a very good chance he won't even fire. He'll run and, you know, try to use one of his psionic powers. Okay, and there's the faceless. That's a thing. Yeah, this could be bad. Yes. Well, he didn't miss, but he didn't kill him. You know what sucks? I have 100% shot here, and I can't afford to stay there and take it. Almost for sure. I also have a real problem in general having a good shot this turn. Okay, how about I do this? I'm going to bring her over here. Rolling. Can I even see the stupid faceless from there? No. No, because of the doorway. Well, it's more because of the wall. All right.
Solid copy.
Well, what we're going to do is bring everybody over this way. And not coincidentally, away from that thing.
Order's confirmed.
And then we're going to throw a little surprise party for a certain faceless. So I'm just going to pull him back with the others. Faceless do not get to attack coming off of a dash. They only get to attack, you know, after their first move. Not all melee opponents are like that. Certainly stun lancers are not. Oh, don't do that. Don't do that. That's unfortunate. I'm still pretty confident we'll kill him, but that did not help. Okay. Yeah. Save your posing, poser. 99%. Hit him, Lucas. Sorry, I thought I clicked the button. For some reason, it didn't, the game did not agree. 58%. Okay, let's try you, Christian. There we go.
Target neutralized.
Baseless down. We just have the sectoid. And here's the thing, we have 5 left here. I need 4 of them. So now that the faceless has been revealed, I know that that 5 is a real number. I wasn't positive if the counter worked that way. I'm going to take this shot. Okay. I wish I had another grenade, but I don't. I'm going to start putting her in a position to hit him. This shot isn't good enough for me to leave her behind half cover, so I'm going to hunker down. I don't like that my Ranger is behind half cover, actually. Okay, we're all right. At least I think so. So she's not disoriented anymore. Let's go, hold on. What are my odds? 62%. Now, if I moved, I'd get way better, but of course, he'd get his Overwatch. Actually, you know what? I don't need to do any of that. I got the perfect move right here. Shadowfall, 100%. Boom, you're dead. So long, sectoid.
Hostile neutralized.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
All right, well, we didn't get there especially pretty. 2 soldiers wounded, but no soldiers killed. And we did manage to get 7 civilians out of here. And I don't feel like that map was set up any too friendly for us. Most of the civilians were well back in the map. You know, right where the aliens were, and they were mowing them down at a pretty good clip. So I'm grateful that we were able to get back there pretty quickly, and, you know, put a stop to that. I definitely don't like activating a group when I don't have all of my squad in position to fight. I just felt like in this instance, if I didn't do that, we were really going to be screwed. Now, I admit, the Faceless coming, that made it a lot more tense. Because without that, you know, we had it. We had it pretty easily. But we got there. We even got promotions for two of my guys. Wow, I hate this. I hate that amount of time. You know what? I'm just going to go Revival here. Especially with Panic being such a frequent thing. And I'll take Scouting Phantom for him. All right.
Hello, Commander.
Plus 15 supplies. That's going to turn the tide. All right, supply drop. I'm thinking the supply drop would be a good thing for us. And then we'll start heading back for that engineer. I don't know. I'm actually really tempted to just start building the AWC. Part of me knows I should build resistance comms and then power, but I gotta be honest, like, these hospital times just ate me they ate me alive in our last campaign, and I feel like the same thing is gonna happen. Okay, I unfortunately just don't have 170 supplies to give away, as much as I would love, you know, to get that. So let's just do this. I don't want this to go away. I need an engineer. That's no lie.
Commander, we have a priority.
Hello, Commander. It would seem your recent activities have gotten Advent's attention. Our unwelcome guests are on the move. Advent has been diverting considerable resources and personnel to covert facilities across the globe. The exact details of these operations are highly classified. However, they do have one thing in common. A single word that appears in all their files. Avatar. I believe the black site we had previously uncovered to be but a part of this Avatar project. Based on what we have uncovered so far, its true scope is far greater. This project is being directed from the very top of Advent, from a source I am still unable to determine. All attempts to uncover its identity have met with failure. It is time to take a more direct approach. Though we may not know the exact nature of this Avatar project, we can still disrupt it. We must root out these hidden facilities with the help of local resistance cells, disrupt our enemy's operations, and in the process, uncover the truth. Locate the source of this Avatar project, and then destroy it. Were the enemy to succeed in their efforts, I am certain it would mean the end for us all. I am confident you will take whatever measures necessary to eliminate this threat, Commander.
We're tracking the aliens' progress on this Avatar project here. If they finish what they've started, it sounds like it'll be the end for all of us.
That would be bad. Okay, well, they don't want to give me control. Here we go. All right, let's see if we can finish this. No, we cannot. So, we again only have the one target. I need to open up more areas, that's why. So, what are we going to do? We're going to protect a device. If we make it, we'll get 179 supplies. You know, if that happened, I might even go ahead and cough up for one of the guys we could recruit. That or the other possibility, I mean, I could try to just build the Advanced Warfare Center. That price is, like, dead on. It would help us so much, so much, if we could spend less hospital time, you know, have, I'm not saying it well, if our soldiers could spend less time in the hospital. All right, well, look, that's a concern for another day, because that's all for now. Thanks for watching. I hope we see you next time.